Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. So we were discussing about the built-in decorators, and we already discussed about the property decorator in the previous tutorial. So today in this tutorial we are discussing about the class method and static method decorators. Okay, so for that, first of all, in Python there are two types of variables and three types of methods. The two types of variables are: first one is instance variable and second one is class variable, and we can use three types of method. That is, one is instance method, class method, third one is static method. And to write this class method and static method, we'll use that decorators, that is class method decorator and static method decorator. So before learning these two, we'll see what is this instance method and instance variable and class variable in short. So for that, I'll take a class first. So here we can see a class student. It contains two methods, that is the initialization method and message method. So here we can see the client side code. It will print the value of variables as well as it will call the method. So here we can see name and age. These are the two variables of this class. And these variables are called as instance variable, because here we can see these variables inside the method, and here we can see we are initializing it like this, self.name. Here, what is self actually? Self is nothing but object itself, right? So instance variables are owned by the instance of class, okay? Object, it's owned by the objects itself. So for the each object or instance of class, the instance variables are different. For example, if I take s1.name, this is one object, and s1.age, now name is Nia, age is 20. And if I take another object called s2, here name is Ria and age is 21. We can see the name and age are different for different object. Okay, so that's why these are called as instance variable. And we'll define the instance variable inside the method like this. Here we can see it is inside the method, right? So this is about the instance variable. Next, instance method. So here this message is the instance method, because here we can see self, we are passing the first parameter as self. Self is nothing but the object itself, right? So this is the instance method. So instance methods are the most common type of methods in Python classes. They are called as instance methods because they can access unique data of their instance. So now if I save this and run this, here we can see Nia 20, Nia 20, it will print. For object 2, we can see Ria 21, Ria 21. Okay, so this is about the instance variable and instance method. Next, we'll talk about the class variable. So we'll define the class variable inside the class, outside the methods. Here, we define the instance variable inside the method, but class method will be present outside the method, and it is bound to class. And all the objects of that class can use that variable. So for example, here I'll take college name, okay? Here I'll think all the students are learning in a college called XYZ. So all the students are belongs to same college. So here I define the college name variable. So now this college name is defined here outside the method inside the class. So this is called as class variable. It belongs to this class. We can call this class variable using class as well as object. So I'll show you. If I call s1.collegename, I need to print this, and here also I'll print that. Here I'll take s2.collegename. If I save this and run this, here we can say it will print XYZ and XYZ. Okay, so the class variable can be accessed by all the objects of that class, or we can access it using class also. For example, I'll remove this. Okay, now if I access it using class name, student.collegename, print, here we can see it will print XYZ. Okay, so class variables are defined within the class construction, and they are owned by the class itself, and class variables are shared by all the objects of that class. Okay, So this is about the class variable, and instance method. So now we'll talk about the class method and static method. So first we'll talk about the class method and we'll see how it is different from the instance method. In the instance method, what we'll do is we'll pass the objects, right? We'll write the self. If I define method like message, here the first argument of the instance method will be self. That is nothing but we are passing the object itself. But in the class method, we are not passing the object because this is the class method. So here it will contain CLS, that is nothing but class. Okay, we are passing class itself. So the class methods know about their class. Class method don't need the self as an argument, but they need a parameter as CLS that represents the class. And to create this class method, we'll use class method decorators. So I'll show you the syntax here. We need to write like this. If we are writing inside a class, okay. Here we need to write def, okay, and method name. So the first parameter of class method should be CLS. Then it contains other parameters, okay. Then this is the body. And to create this, we need to use the decorator class method here. Okay, so this is the syntax. So now we'll see an example. So here we can see we have a simple class. It contains the instance variable and instance method. Now, if I want to check how many objects are created from this class, okay, so then I can do that using class method. So for that, first of all, I'll take a class variable called counter. I'll initialize it to 0. So when we know whenever the object is created, it will execute this initialization method, right? So here I'll increment the counter. So counter is the variable of class. So I need to call this like this. Student.counter is equal to student.counter plus 1. So whenever the object is created, it will execute this initialization method. Then I'll increment the counter by 1. Next, I'll define this class method. If you want to change the class, then you can use class method. So def, I can give any name. So here I'll give object count. So first parameter should be CLS. And I don't want any other parameter here. So here I'll return CLS.counter. Okay, so I need to write here class method to make it class method. So here counter will contain the count and we are accessing it using a class. So now here if I call that, to call that I need to use the class name, right? Student.objectCount. I need to print this. So now if I save this and run this, it will print 2. Two objects are there here, right? If I create another one and if I execute, it will print 3. And another thing is we can call this class method using object also. For example, copy this and paste this, and here instead of class name I'll write it as s1, that is the object name. Now if I save this and run this, it will also print 3. Okay, so we can call the class method using object as well as class name. So to create the class method, we need to use class method decorator. And in the class method, the first parameter should be CLS, not self. We don't want self here. And no need to externally pass class here because it will automatically pass the class, like in the instance method. I'll take another example for this. So here what we'll do is, here we can see we are taking marks like this. We are giving the percentage like 93, 67, 67. Okay, so I'll remove this. So now our client will come to us and will ask, I don't want to give the percentage. I'll give the marks, whether you can convert it and can you print the percentage? We can, right? If marks is given, we can calculate the percentage. For example, he'll give like this, marks equal to 560. He'll give the marks, and name is equal to like Sia. Okay, so I'll take string. Now what we need to do is, first we need to calculate the percentage of the marks, then we need to call this function. Okay, so I'll remove this class method now, because we are taking another example, right? I don't want counter also. This is the simple class now, which contains instance variable and instance method, which will print name and the marks in the percentage. So now we can do like this. I can convert the marks here, like marks divided by 600. So I'll take total marks as 600. You can calculate in any way, 100. Okay, so I'll convert the marks here. This is the input. He want to give input like this. Next, I'll create another object called student, and I'll pass this name and marks 1. Okay, here marks is given like this, and we have converted that to percentage, and now we are passing the percentage. Now if I call message, so s2.message, it should print, should remove this. Okay, and one thing is left here. We can see this is string, right? So to convert this, first I need to change to int. Next here I need to convert it to string. Here what I'm doing is, here client will give the input in the marks. I need to convert that to percentage, and I need to pass that as the percentage to this method. Okay, so for that what I did is, first I'll convert that to percentage. So for that I converted the marks to int, and I calculate the value. After that I will again convert it to string, because here we are passing the strings. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, it will print Sia got in the percentage. Okay, so now client can give input in the marks, and we can convert it to percentage, and he can give. But the problem is, if I create another object and I want to do the same thing again, right? Instead of that, what we can do is, we can create a class method here, and we can do these changes in that class method. Then we can call that class method whenever we want. So that is nothing but, instead of this, okay, what we can do is, here we can create a class method. For that I can give any name. I'll give get percentage, and here CLS, and I want marks and name. Okay, so I'll take this. I'm modifying class here, so it will return class with name as first parameter, and for marks I'll copy this. Okay, it will do these changes, and it will return the class now. So no need to do changes for every marks now, for every object now. Okay, so here at class method. So now what we can do is, instead of doing this, I can call like this, okay, student, the class name dot get percentage, and here he can give directly name and marks. Now if I save this and run this, see, I got 93. It will print that. Okay, class method decorator is helpful to create a class method. So we can use class method whenever we want to do any changes to class. So this is about the class method decorator. So next we'll talk about the static method decorator. The static method decorator is similar to the class method decorator, and this static method decorator is helpful to create the static method. But as we saw in the instance method and in the class method, there should be a specific first parameter, right? In the instance method, that is self. In the class method, it should contain this CLS as the first parameter. But in static method, there is no rule like that. There is no need of mentioning any specific parameter. It works like a regular function, but somehow belongs to the class. So if I define a regular function outside the class, okay, then how will you do that? We'll use def keyword and the function name. If I say function name, and here parameter list, right? And this is the function body. So we'll define static method like this only, but inside the class. We'll use method name here, okay, df method name and parameter list. But here we need to mention at static method to create that. So we'll see the example. So this is the student class, right? So now I'll define a static method, like I'll check the age of the students. So simply I'll check df get age, and here I'll take age. There is no class, there is no self, okay? I'll just mention the parameter, and here I'll check the age, whether age is less than 17, okay? If age is less than 17, then I'll print, okay, they are belongs to this school. If else, if their age is greater than 17, then they are in some different college. So I'll print they don't belongs to school, they are in different college, okay? So now static method. Now if I mention student dot get age, here we can see belongs to school because I took age as 16, right? Now if I can access it using object also, s1 belongs to school. If you ask why you written this code, means I just wanted to show how this static code will work. It won't take any self or class, okay? You can write like this, just we can mention the parameter and we can do this. So next we'll see what is the difference between static and class method. So these are the difference. Pause the video and read it. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.